right, peasant. I've had just about enough of this. You will tell us what you know, or else we'll have to get some answers by force. Now tell us, why did you send the threat to Her Majesty?
Oh, stop it with the tears, you shrimp. You won't get out of this any faster by turning on the waterworks.
All right, that's it. You there, fetch me my personal favorite toy.
Oi, you, keep quiet. This'll just hurt more if you struggle.
Unless you want to confess. Come on, shrimp, just tell us your guilt.
What on earth is going on down here?
Your Majesty, we apologize for waking you.
At ease, Rickon. What are you... Oh my god. What have you done?
Your Highness, this peasant was delivering this. A note threatening your highest majesty.
Never mind that. You've scared the poor thing half to death.
But your majesty...
Both of you, go. You are to finish this poor thing's work for the rest of the day, seeing that you've made them tied up with you two. Go. And when you get back, I expect both of you to make this up to this person and their family.
Yes, your majesty.
There you are. You poor thing. Shh. It's all right. Here, let me help you up. Shh. It's all right, dear. Let's go get you all cleaned up and relaxed, okay? Shh. Please, let me help you. What you just went through was so scary, I know. I know that they're so intimidating at times. Though, if it makes you feel any better, I intimidate them more. Ah. Probably not too helpful. Here, let's get you up the stairs. Ah, oh, there you are. Oh, and I must say, you do look rather comfortable right now. Do the clothes fit you all right? I'm glad that they're soft. Ah, I've prepared you some tea. Come. Come sit with me. Oh, no need to be shy, dear. You can sit closer if you like. I won't mind. There. See? Now you're closer to the fire. Here you are. Sugar? Oh, Of course. Feeling better after a nice bath? A bit? That's good. You still seem a bit shaken. Oh, I feel so terribly bad. Might I, if you're comfortable, that is, might I help dry your hair? Perhaps it'll keep the chill of the night from getting to you faster. Thank you. Oh my, so soft. I'm quite surprised, honestly. I'm glad that the lower class is beginning to take better care of themselves. Ever since we won the Battle of Merryman Hill and claimed our spoils of the war, we have been able to spend more money helping the peasant folk. I'm glad to see our work is finally paying off. Oh, darling, you're trembling. Whatever's the matter? Shh, shh, shh. Slow down, slow down. It's all right. Hey, please take a deep breath for me. Breathe in. And out. There you are. There you are. Here. Drink some tea. It should help you calm you down. What? No, no, dear one, no. I don't think it was you who sent the letter. I know it wasn't you. Oh, no need to cry. Shh, come here, come here. Let me hug you. There we are. Yes, yes, I know you're innocent. It's all right. How do I know? Oh, darling, I have many powerful enemies. I don't think a simple messenger would have any reason to send me a threat. Despite what I said earlier, this war is not yet won. If I hadn't gotten any threats, I think I would have been more panicked of a bigger conspiracy brewing underneath. Do I think? Oh, dear. I'm afraid I do not have an answer. Our enemies are strong, but I do not want to give the kingdom false hope. This is a difficult battle. If Wisteria gets what they want, then I fear this world will advance beyond what is capable for the human mind to understand, and dark and trying age. Though, I suppose, it's the small victories we must celebrate for now. That's a good question. Quite intelligent, aren't you? Well, I suppose we put the money towards the people, because we need to keep those who are fit to fight in proper condition. It's a bit selfish, isn't it? Oh, no need to apologize. You're quite right. The court says that's the reasoning behind it. But mine is my father. All he ever wanted was to help his people live a wonderful, happy, and carefree life. Now that he's gone, I only feel it's right that I continue his work, even with the disapproval of my court. God, what he must think of me. Of me dragging his peaceful kingdom to war. That's kind of you to say. Thank you. As a ruler, I must do my best to keep my chin up and stay strong. Oh, enough about me, though. What about you? What are things like in the village? Well, of course I'm interested. I don't go down there nearly enough. Oh, pretty bad, huh? I suppose the money would only have enough to last for a bit. Maybe if I just... maybe no. Maybe... Oh, my apologies, dearest. Do repeat that. Oh my, what a polite little thing. Thank you. It is a rather lovely room, isn't it? This used to be my mother's sitting room. The Queen's personal escape from the world. You may use anything you'd like in this room while you're here. There is an ink and quill on the desk over there, along with a lot of parchment. There's a rather comfortable blanket and chair just over there if you want to take a nap. And of course, the bookcases. You look awestruck, my dear. It is quite a lot of books, isn't it? Do you read often? Your face is all red. How silly a messenger who cannot read. Uh-oh, I didn't mean to make fun of you, dear. There's no need to be bashful. I know a lot of folks who cannot read or write. If you don't mind me asking, though, how do you deliver the letters if you can't read who they're for? Ah, it's a bit of a struggle, isn't it, huh? You just follow where the others tell you to go. Oh, I'm sorry, darling. I didn't mean to startle you like that. Tell me, do you remember who told you to deliver that letter? There was no name or address on it. A cloaked figure, waiting on the road in the forest. Which road? The one headed towards Westhaven or Brookson? Oh, yes, yes. You might have just figured this one out for me. There was one clue on the page. Yes, you've seen the symbol before. On the arm. Yes, I know who sent this. They're planning on making an advance. With this information you just gave me, we might be able to stop them in their tracks. What a wonderful gift you are, my dear. I wonder, when you go, would you deliver a message to Diego for me? He's a vampire lord up the hill. Yes, that one. Oh, don't worry. I promise he won't bite. Of course, you may leave whenever you like. The guards who arrested you. Dear, don't listen to a word those fools have to say. You can go home whenever you wish. Additionally, you may stay here for as long as you need. I can have my guards take over your deliveries forever if you wanted. Although, darling, if I were to ask you to join me, would you come? You could help us end this war. You'd be seen as a hero to all the people. Ah, the people. Your family. I understand. No need to apologize. I understand you have a life here. I shouldn't be ruining this moment, with talk of war. Although, I would like to see you again. What if I were to teach you to read? You could come and visit me once a week, and we could sit in the garden with any book of your choice. You'd like that? I'm glad. Ah, guards. You're back.
We, picked some flowers for you, Shrimpy.
And the nicest looking cake from the bakery. We, hope you like it.
We're sorry for, arresting you and stuff.
Well, What do you say, dear? Do you forgive them? No. Oh, my. Well, then what should we do to teach them a lesson?
Wait, we're sorry.
I can't lose my job.
It won't happen again.
Please,
for the love of God, we brought cake.
Ah, you forgive them now. All right, my dear. My, you look quite sleepy. Your room is just through those doors, dear. You're welcome to stay here for the night. And come and get me if you need anything. Good night, my dear.
Night, Shrimpy. What do we do now, Your Majesty?
Well, we find them and go after the enemies to the south. Stop the black mages from coming.
But ma'am, they're a peaceful people. Is it really wise to attack them?
It sends a message, you Nimrod. A chain is only as good as its weakest link. Or, in this case, its most peaceful, vulnerable link.
And the shrimp?
Keep an eye on them. With their job, they have access to all sorts of information. Now it's a matter of getting them to tell me. I will start their reading lessons immediately. Soon no letter will be safe. All secrets will come tumbling out of the shrimpy's lips. Poor thing. Don't even know what they're doing. Now go prepare my coach. I need to go visit an old friend.
Yes,
ma'am.
Lady, I really think you should sit down.
I'm all right, Jane.
Ma'am, I don't think this level of stress and anxiety is good for your health. You're beginning to look unwell.
We must continue our advance into Killshire. I have no time for rest. Go tell Captain Osmond to bring out the catapults.
But ma'am, the Killshirans are unarmed and weak. If we attack them, then...
If we attack all the small fish in the pond, it will lure out the big fish.
Wisteria.
Yes, wisteria. Tell the men to prepare. Our battle starts now.
Who dares enter here? In the mansion of the great and powerful lord? Oh, you're the queen's messenger. The one peasant whom she took a liking to. Oh, well, please, please come in. We have been expecting you. May I take your coat? Thank you. Please make yourself comfortable. Ah, yes, introductions. I am Lord Diego. Oh, but you probably knew that. Anyways, what is this message that my dear friend has to share with me? Ah. Oh no. Ah, yes. Well, it's not much. She mentions you and how sweet you are. She gave me some updates on the current situation of the war. It seems like she's in Kilshire at the moment. Oh, no, don't worry, dear. I'm sure she's fine. She and her father were built to lead. They are smart, strong-willed, and very scary when they need to be. She's determined to end the ongoing war between us and Wisteria. I'm sure it'll work out. Though if she continues to use the tactics I think she's using... Ah, no, don't worry about it. How about some tea? Excellent! So, tell me about yourself. Ah, I see. And your name is...
Was that someone I heard knocking just now?
Ah, yes. Human, this is...
Lady Imogen Acre, Lord Diego's niece. Pleasure to meet you. Oh, you're Astria's new interest, aren't you? Well, of course we know. I've got great ears, dear. Well, you are the talk of the town, after all. It's not every day a messenger is taken into custody and comes out hours later as a trusted messenger to Her Majesty. Well, of course you are. She only lets those closest to her deliver her letters. She usually gets a maid or another close servant to do it. But you?
Yes, it is a bit odd, isn't it? Oh, well, yes, I have known the Queen since we were children. Her father and mine were friends. That is until... Well, suffice to say, the Queen is a kind woman when she wants to be. Despite my vampiric nature, she still helped me when I was newly turned.
Please, Uncle. We all know the Queen's true intentions are not to make friends. We're simply all pawns that somehow fit into her plan.
Imogen, that is unkind. The Queen has done more for me than my own father did.
The Queen refused to marry you as soon as you turned. Uncle, she has done nothing for you.
Despite it all, she is not an unkind ruler. She could have killed me or sold me out when I turned. Instead, she offered me her blood and a mansion secluded on the hill. She changed the way people saw non-humans in our village.
Yes, she could have killed you, but she took my father instead. Look, human, if I were you, keep your guard up around her. She speaks kindly, but her intentions are not always what she says they are. Look, believe me or not, I don't care. But keep your guard up. Would you deliver this to one of my friends for me? Lady Lilith Jacobs. She just lives on the next hill over. Thank you. Now, if you'll excuse me, I should be going. Look out for yourself, won't you?
I'll walk you to the door. You'll have to forgive Imogen for me. The death of her father was not one she has gotten over yet. grief. Despite how many centuries one can live, grief will always remain. The Queen and I? Yes, she and I were set to be married to one another many years ago. My father was furious with her father at the time, so he turned me, and the king cast me out of his castle. I'd like to think she still misses me. Thinks of what might have been. I still do. That, dear child, is my grief. Thank you. Please be careful on your way back.
Welcome back. I do hope your work for the day went well. Oh, I'm sure you're exhausted. Here, why don't you come relax with me? I had my servants prepare a few dishes for you. I trust you made it to Diego's all right. Excellent. Are you all right? Here. Why don't you gather the snacks you want? And I'll brush your hair while you tell me about your day. Oh, really? Then you went to Lord Diego's. And? I see. And I... Oh, darling, is that a lip stain on your cheek? Here, let me clean it off. Lady Imogen. That woman is such a harlot. Go on, then. What did she say about me this time? She told you what? That I? Oh, darling. I hope you don't think of me as someone who's capable of committing something like that. What happened to her father was unfortunate, but it was an event I took no part in. I hope you never think of me like that. What happened to him? Truthfully? I can say I don't really know. What about Diego? Yes, it is true that he and I did love each other once. But his father became jealous of mine and took away our opportunity to marry. Why couldn't we? Truthfully, I don't know what caused Lord Ikor's anger, but... Oh, why couldn't we marry after his death? Well, I should think it's obvious. For centuries, my family ruled over this land. We could not let a vampire rule. So instead, he inherited his father's money after my father had banished the old Lord Ikor. Far, far away from here. Ever since then, Diego has been living in a wonderful mansion I had built for him. His niece, Imogen, unfortunately, moved in with him shortly after her mother passed, a few years ago, after the death of her husband. Diego turned Imogen, and now she'll be the one to inherit and become Lady Ikor of Ikor Manor. Do I still think about him? Truthfully, I don't. There is nothing I can do to change what happened. Having those sorts of thoughts make me weak and vulnerable. Oh, but darling, we're talking about you. Do you like sweets? I'm glad. Which one's your favorite? Perhaps I can have someone prepare it before your next reading lesson. You like them all. I'm glad. I like all of them too. So, sweetness, did you? Oh my, your face is all red. How cute. Do you like the nickname I gave you? Sweetness? Well, I'm glad that you like it. As I was saying, did you have any interesting letters today? Nothing out of the ordinary then. Oh, except a letter about... My, what a scandal. I didn't know peasant folk got up to those sort of things. Lady Imogen asked you to deliver something as well. To whom? Lady Lilith Jacobs. I see. And pray tell, what did the letter say? The lark broke free from her cage. Oh my, how odd. Must be a silly little saying. Oh, but I'm very proud of how far your reading and comprehension skills have come. I think you're about ready to start reading novels now. Oh, don't be frightened. You'll do wonderfully. And I'm here to help you every step of the way, all right? Wonderful. I do think you're a treasure, my little sweetness. Ah, I almost forgot. I have another letter for you. Would you read it out loud for me? Yes, yes. It's an invitation to a tea party event I'm hosting at the end of this week. So, will you join me? Wonderful. Be here at 6 o'clock sharp. Don't keep me waiting, sweetness.
Thank you.
you are, sweetness. You look wonderful, my dear. Oh, you really do clean up nicely. How are you feeling? Nervous? Ah, your first tea party. I understand. Please, come along. The servants have just finished up setting up the garden. I think you'll find the flowers are rather lovely this time of year. Come, come. I knew you'd like it. Ah, our guests must be arriving. Shall we? Good afternoon, ladies. Thank you for coming. Let's get the introductions out of the way. Sweetness, this is Lady Annabelle Moore, one of my most dear friends.
How do you do?
Lady Lilith Jacobs.
A pleasure to make your acquaintance.
And you already know, Lady Imogen. Now, shall we get settled in for tea?
Why don't you come sit next to me, darling?
Sweetness, please come sit by me.
I see. No worries, dear.
Say, Imogen, did you hear about the farmer in the village?
What about them?
Well, turns out he went to a forest and got himself turned into an ass.
No way. You're making that up.
It's true. Came home all silly because of his running with Faye. Hello there. You look a touch nervous. Are you all right? Oh, I see. You live in the village, don't you? Oh, you must be the messenger Callan wrote to me about. I heard you got into quite a bit of trouble with my cousin. Yes, Callan is my cousin. He told me of how he and dearest Rickon arrested you. Such a scary thing. Oh yes, he wrote about you quite a lot. He referred to you in his letter only as Shrimpy. Ah, a nickname given to you by him, I see. Callan was always one for teasing nicknames. Don't let it get to you. Hmm? What did he say about you? Only how he'd seen you deliver letters to the castle. A smile any time you completed your job, and how your eyes would wander around the beauty of the large buildings around you. He also mentioned how he deeply regretted ever scaring an innocent person like that. I'll tell you a secret. Callan hates his job. Had it not been for a deal with the Queen, he probably would be living a peaceful life as a farmer. Oh, pardon me, I don't mean to gossip. Are you enjoying your tea?
I would like to thank you all for coming to attend tea with me today, especially with such short notice.
Well, it's not like we had much of a choice, now did we? Can't ignore a summons from the Queen. Pardon the intrusion. I do like to arrive fashionably late.
Late, yes, but fashionable?
Ah, how silly, Imogen. Undead, and you still manage to find situations to make jokes.
Good to see you too, Meredith.
Ah yes, sweetness, this is...
Duchess Meredith Crawford. And who is this sweet thing?
This is...
They can introduce themselves. Go on, dear. Oh, a messenger, hmm? How interesting. Now, I do hope you haven't had too much fun without me.
We're glad you're here, Meredith.
Oh well, I did travel all the way from Whitebridge to be here, so I do hope that you're glad. Now, tell me, messenger, dear, why are you exactly here? Hmm? The Queen's new partner, perhaps? Ah, my Maestrea. Look at the blush on their cheeks. Is this person really yours?
They are quite adorable, aren't they? This is the peasant I've been teaching to read.
I see. Say, dear, would you mind passing me some biscuits? They look delicious. Thank you.
Ignore Lady Meredith. She's my mother's cousin. If anything were to happen to me on the throne, it would go to her. I agree it's rubbish, but try to be kind, relax, and give her a compliment. Just be yourself, and I think she'll leave you alone.
What was that, dear? You think I look nice? Well, how sweet of you, dear. You don't look terribly bad yourself.
Nicely done. I'm proud of you. Now, enjoy your tea. Sit up straight. That's it.
Imogen, what do you think about them?
Think about who?
The messenger, the stuff about the letters.
Well, they're kind, very sweet, and awkwardly adorable. I don't think they're doing it on purpose, but I do agree. Them being this close to the Queen is suspicious. Just try to relax, Lilith. You'll be all right.
Everyone seems to be having a good time, don't you think? I agree. Imogen, Lilith, I do hope you two aren't gossiping over there.
Not at all. We were just admiring your messenger. Tell me, messenger, have you always lived in Cordelia Village? Oh, I see. So where did you live before?
Why does it matter to you, Lilith?
Can't a lady simply be curious about who's delivering her letters? For all we know, they could be a spy, Your Majesty.
Oh, Lilith. Always the one jumping to conclusions.
But in this case, I'm right. Aren't I? Why have you taken such interest in his peasants if they weren't working for you? I see no royal symbol on their clothing, on their messenger's back. They worked for the group of messengers in this village, and all of a sudden, they are delivering letters for the upper class. What happened to the last postman, Astrea? What happened to Charlie?
Enough! Tis wartime. One must keep an eye on her enemies.
Enemies?
We are not your enemies, Your Majesty.
No, but you aren't my friends either.
I I'm afraid I don't understand.
You see, a letter was sent to me several weeks ago. After getting the threatening note, I realized I have so many enemies. I must begin to keep an eye on things.
You mean evade our private letters? Some of those were only meant...
for Imogen's eyes. How you poured your heart and soul into those letters, telling her how you longed to be by her side more, how she will comfort you on cold nights, how she will protect you in the danger of this war.
Stop it.
How, oh, if my father knew my feelings for you, he surely would send me far from this house. But to be with you would make it most worth it.
Stop. Stop. Stop.
Leave her alone, you snake.
You think you can step up to me, Imogen? Don't be a fool. You have secrets, too. The vampire gang to the north. You've sent them money. Money you have stolen from your uncle. How would he feel if I told him?
You wouldn't. You wouldn't dare speak to Diego. Why should he believe you anyways?
And you. Poor, sweet, precious Annabelle. You? Sweetness? No. Sit down. I said sit. Good. Annabelle. Practicing unsupervised necromancy magic in her basement.
I...
And you, Meredith? Well, I really just don't like you.
Well then, why did you invite us here? Just to babble out all of our secrets?
No, I wanted to invite you all here as a warning. No letter, no secret, and no plan against me will ever go unchecked in this country. All of your plans to take me down will fail. I have eyes everywhere, ears everywhere. And your letters that plot against me will not be delivered. I don't know which one of you had a servant send me the threatening letter, but it doesn't matter now. All that matters now is you know who the power is held by. You know that I hold all the power, the information I can get, the... Dear, what are you doing? Why are you... Oh, God, you're crying. No. Don't back away here. It's all right. Sweetness, come back!
Well, I think we're done here. Ladies?
What have I done?
Astraea, what you're doing, it's wrong.
You don't have.
Just listen to me. Don't make an enemy out of those who don't have to be. Don't hurt that poor messenger of yours. Just... We want to be on your side, Astraea. But we're on the side of our kingdom, on the side of Cordelia. I'm sorry.
dear.
A spy. What happened to Charlie, Astrea?
It was your fault.
You told her our secrets.
Did you grow up in Cordelia?
Why exactly are you here?
The nightmares. Have they come back? Here, Mama said that water helps. I brought you some. Drink, drink! You're welcome. I love you.
Hey, how are you doing? Good, that's good. That's great. So, I was wondering if... Come on, Callan, you've got this. You're just gonna go and talk to them. No big deal. Shrimpy, are you awake? It's Callan, the guard. Ah, there you are, Shrimpy. I just wanted to check in on you. Yesterday's tea party, I heard, got pretty intense. Oh, yes. We could hear what went down. You guys weren't exactly being quiet about it, and I was worried about you. Yeah, of course, all those wealthy women picking on you, you walking out after, I was worried. What? Why are you laughing? Don't laugh at me. You're much crueler than I thought you were, Shrimpy. I'm only joking. But, seriously, are you okay? Well, that's good. I mean, good.
Oh, can I just stick that?
Right, look. I came here because I have a letter for you. Yes, for you. It's... just read it. What? Oh, that word. It's affection. That word? Admire. You know what? Just let me read it. Dear Shrimpy, I would like to formally apologize for arresting you. Although I can't say I regret it, because then I would never have gotten to meet you and express my affection for you. Don't grin at me like that, just... Look, the point is, I think you're really cute. Kind. And since you... Well, I've set up breakfast deep in the gardens, and I was wondering if you'd like to join me. Say it slower? You really are teasing me, Shrimpy. I said, will you join me for breakfast in the garden? You will? You need to get ready. Yes, of course. I'll go get ready too.
Whoa, where are you off to so quickly, lad?
Lord Diego, my apologies, sir.
No need to apologize. Callan, is it?
Yes, sir. I was just headed to the garden. I am eating breakfast with a friend.
I see. You've taken a liking to that dear messenger, have you?
Sir, how did you...
It's not hard to tell. They are a sweet little thing.
Indeed, sir, but pardon me, sir. What are you here for?
Well, as it were, I'm here to speak to a friend, too.
Oh, well, I wish the best of luck to you, my lord.
And I you. Oh, and Callan, have fun, all right? The ballroom. I forgot this was here. Gods above. It's filthy.
Come. To declare yourself my enemy as well.
Astrea. Imogen told me about the party.
I don't give a damn what Imogen said to you.
Why did you do it?
I don't know. I don't know. I feel like no one's on my side here.
Astrea, it's because you don't let anyone on your side. You push everyone away when they try to help you. You're so closed off and afraid.
I fear nothing.
You're afraid. I can see it. You brought all of those women here just to, what? To scare them away from plotting against you? None of them had. You know it. You just don't want anyone close to you to betray you. Like... Whatever happened in your past, whatever you're hiding, it pains me to see you hurt. But you don't have to push away anymore. I'm here. I'm here to help you. If only you would let me.
I can't.
Whoa, you look wonderful. Or fine, you look fine. Just, come on. Hmm? Oh yeah, flowers are in full bloom. Beautiful, isn't it? See those over there? Those are the Cordelia flowers. Oh, and those there? Those are Queen Astria's favourites. Forget-me-nots. Coincidentally, I forget why those are her favourite. How do I know all this? Well, I guess I just love flowers. My mother's been selling flowers off our farm for as long as I can remember. What? Annabelle? What about Annabelle? She told you that I hate this job? No, she's wrong. It's not that I hate this job, it's just that I don't enjoy it. We're here. Go on, sit. What do I enjoy? I really do enjoy farming. My younger sisters and I have grown up on our family's farm. I've worked there ever since I can remember. There's just some sort of peace about all of it, you know? But enough about me. You never really talk about yourself much. What do you enjoy? You enjoy delivering letters, huh? You know, I think that's really cool, actually. I know lots of people who would complain about having to walk that far every day. You're a really strong person. Do you miss it? Delivering letters. I know that ever since you've gotten wrapped up with us, the Queen has had you be the noble folk's personal messenger. And, that's what I want to apologize for. I'm sorry for getting you into this mess. Honestly, when you brought the letter, I thought it was odd, but we had no other suspect. Rickon told me to go after you, and so I went after you. I feel bad about it, but you're taught to be ruthless in a job like mine. It's the royal family's safety at stake. But it's not good if it threatens an innocent person too. And I know it doesn't make up for it, but I brought you some more of that cake you enjoyed. I hope you- Whoa! I'm glad you like it. This feels nice. I haven't been hugged like this in a long time. I mean, you'd better let go and eat the food I got for you. I know, it's good, right? I bought it from Martha Baker in the village. In my opinion, buying things from there always tastes much better than the stuff the castle makes. Not that they're bad cooks, mind you, it's just that the bakery stuff tastes a lot more like home. Yeah, I agree. Hey, that gives me an idea. The village is holding a festival next week. You heard? Great. So, I was wondering, would you like to go with me? As friends, of course. Not for any other reason. Oh, you're laughing at me again. All right, that's it. You get over here. I'm gonna catch you, you little shrimp.
You can't? What do you mean you can't?
I mean I can't, Diego. I just can't.
Astrea.
I don't know who to trust anymore. My own siblings left me. My own mother. My father died.
Astrea.
And I know everyone wants to know what happened, and I just can't tell them. The kingdom would see me as a coward.
You're not a coward.
You said I was afraid.
Astrea! There is a difference between being afraid and being a coward.
Like what?
Well, a coward wouldn't have ever let me drink her blood. A coward would have run as soon as I revealed I had been turned. A coward would have refused the crown and refused all right to the throne. A coward wouldn't dance with me.
What?
May I?
What are you playing at?
Is it really so surprising that I wish to dance with you? We are in a ballroom, after all.
We have no music.
I'll see to that. There it is.
No way.
Oh, yes. A bit dusty, but it'll do.
Oh, goddess.
Now a small snap and... Ah, good. The magic still works.
I'm going to curse that old sorcerer that gave that to you.
Well, it's your fault you didn't want it. Now, come on. Take my hand. It's been far too long since this room has been properly used. Ready to spin?
Oh, God. Whoa.
There you go. You still got it. Now a lift.
Oh, no, Diego. No.
Come on, just like we used to. Ready? I missed that.
So did I. I forgot how fun dancing was.
I wasn't talking about the dancing.
Oh? Oh.
Come with me. The festival next week. You needn't tell me everything, but... let us at least talk.
Diego, I...
Just this once. Then I will bother you no more.
Then I shall.
Until then, my starlight.
Ah, hello there, sweetness. My, where have you been? Ah, enjoyed the day in the garden, did you? Oh? With Callan? I hadn't realized Callan wasn't on duty this morning. Me? Oh, I was just... reminiscing. Say... have you heard about the festival in the village? Thank you.
Isn't it lovely? I always love attending these festivals. Though, in truth, I haven't come down here for a while. Mostly, I just watch from the balcony in my room. It's nice to get out here. Hmm? Oh, this is your first time at the festival. Has your family never attended before? Ah, it never occurred to me that you have no relatives here. Say, where did you live before?
Good evening, Your Majesty. Shrimpy.
Good evening, Callan. Enjoying the festivities?
Indeed, m'lady. Thank you again for the time off. My family appreciated having me home to help with your preparations.
Of course, you deserve it. Oh, Sweetness, are you all right? Why are you hiding behind me? What? Oh. You look fine. Go on, have some fun. No, don't worry about me. I'll walk around and greet people for a while. You know, queen duties. Now go. Callan, I hope you take care of dear old Shrimpy for me. I don't think I could forgive you if something happened to them. Again.
Of course, as a member of the Royal Guard, I swear to protect them. Shrimpy, would you like to, come visit my family's booth? Family's booth, is that the best you could think of? Oh, you will? Great! Goodbye, Your Majesty.
Trying so hard.
Oh, Your Majesty, good evening.
Good evening, dear flower seller. Might I say your blooms are looking wonderful this year?
I agree. They are quite splendid.
Lord Diego, what a pleasure to see you.
One bouquet full of forget-me-nots for the lady, please.
Of course, sir. It is on the house.
No, please, I insist. Have a wonderful evening.
Thank you, my lord. Your Majesty.
You remembered.
How could I forget? The beautiful flowers braided into your blonde hair on those warm summer evenings. I have fond memories of those flowers.
I do too.
Well, it's been a while since you've been into town, hasn't it?
It has been. But, my goodness, the people here seem to love you. Do you come into town often?
I try to support some of our local shops, yes. Though it's exhausting to be out during the day. I prefer evenings like this.
It is lovely.
You're lovely. My apologies. I spoke without thinking.
No, it's all right. I think you're lovely too.
And that over there is my barn. See, you can just see it if you stand on your tip. Whoa! Careful there, Shrimpy. Are you all right? Good, good. Well, would you, like to, go over there now? Cool, cool.
Hey, there you are, my boy.
Hello, Dad. Sales have been going all right?
Oh, yes. We've sold some of our best produce today. Our chickens have done a lovely job. Oh? Who's this?
Dad, this is...
Oh, you must be the sweetheart messenger Cal has been talking so much about.
Dad!
Well, it's a pleasure to meet you. Our Cal seems to like you a lot.
Dad!
Here, I should get the family over here. I'm sure they'd love to meet you. Hey, girls, come on over here. There's someone you should meet.
Thanks, Dad, but we're very busy right now, so we'll just be on our way. Goodbye. What? You're doing that cute evil laugh again. Don't laugh at me. Alright, you. That's enough. Come on. It's beautiful, isn't it? Hmm? Yes, those are real fairies. They come here every year to light up the town. Hmm? Oh yeah, as long as we give them food in return, they don't mind flying around here for a bit. Hey, speaking of, are you hungry? Great, let's head over to the baker's stand.
Ah, good evening, Callan. Good evening, messenger. What can I get for you?
Shrimpy? Cake? Cake it is. 2 slices of chocolate cake, please.
Here you are.
Thank you, sir. Enjoy your evening. Why don't we go and sit down over there? Good choice, Shrimpy. Hmm? What? There's something on my face. Where? You'll... Oh. You're very close now. Thank you. I think you have something on your lip.
Ladies and gentlefolk, welcome! Welcome to the annual Cordelian Festival! Let us come together and enjoy ourselves to the fullest, as we make this a night to truly remember. And who better to make this a memorable night? That's right, we have a special guest with us for this joyous occasion. Bring your hands together, please, as we welcome to the spotlight, all the way from the Kingdom of Constella, Devon Stormglow!
Mwah! Well, a very good evening, lovely Kingdom of Cordelia. It is a pleasure to be here tonight and see so many beautiful faces looking at me. Well, before I get started, I think it's only fair for me to tell you a bit about my mission, about my music. You see, I want to bring something fresh and new to the people of our world, something that is different and unique, something that you haven't heard before. And without any further ado, let's get started.
Well, this is new. Do you like it? Me too.
After a god, she thought it was okay to steal someone's card. Found out she was suspicious of a nothing delicious, and now she is alone and
despondent.
Devon Stoneglow, a famous bard from Constella. I know it's not the kind of music you're used to.
It's awful.
Come on, why don't we go somewhere quieter?
Was a royal named after a god. She thought it was okay to steal someone's card. Found out she was suspicious of a nothing delicious, and now she is alone and despaired. Hey! Oh, Estrella, la 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 la, the queen of hysteria. La,
la. What a lovely evening.
It is. Stars. We should talk.
Can't we enjoy the view?
No, you promised me. Back in the ballroom, you promised me we would at least talk about it.
All right. Do you recall the stories about my grandfather?
Well, of course. King Cornelius William Treadway, founder of Cordelia.
That's correct. Well, the stories frame it as a poor man full of grief who created the kingdom. The truth is he was a very, very bad man. He was banished from his homeland of Wisteria after he attempted to take over the kingdom. He created this kingdom full of conspirators and refugees and declared war on Wisteria. A war that would burden his family for years, generations. When he died, my father swore that he would never be like him. That Cordelia would be a peaceful kingdom. But Wisteria wasn't finished just yet. And my father did nothing.
But
my siblings saw it otherwise. My older brother, the true ruler of Cordelia, was slain in a battle against Wisteria. My older sister, my best friend, had too turned against my father to fight against them. My younger brother and younger sister, they wrote letters after letter, begging for my father's help. Then one day, the letters just stopped coming. I don't know if they were killed or kidnapped, but my father did nothing. Nothing. And I stood by my father in cowardice. My mother was enraged and she left.
You had no one.
I had you. But I was so stupid and I didn't reach out for your help. I rejected you when you could have been there for me. And then my father died and... Diego, I swore I wouldn't be like him. It's a family cycle. I want to protect the people, but... I want Wisteria to be torn down.
My star. This is a war that happened decades ago. Can't we just leave it now? I hear the young King Albert wants to be peaceful and sign a treaty. Why do you insist on fighting still?
Because... it doesn't matter.
Tell me.
Because some little part of me still hopes my siblings are still alive. Some part of me hopes that my little sister is sitting in Albert's castle dungeon, safe and sound. I want to know what happened to them.
You need closure. Hey, come here.
Thank you. Thank you for being here for me.
Of course. I always was.
I apologize. It's unqueenly of me to cry like this.
Oh, hush. You're perfect. Now, come along. I think the people will be quite upset that I've stolen their queen away for a bit.
All right, now, I want to slow things down a bit. I want those of you in the audience tonight to take someone by the hand, and we'll pull them to the dance floor. Come on, everyone!
Shrimpy, where are you? Whoa. You want to dance with me? I'm not very good. I've got two left. Oh, okay then.
You up for a dance, my Starlight?
No, I'd rather not. I don't want to be stuck in a crowd.
Understandable. Why don't we see what else is around?
I'd forgotten how much fun dancing is. Careful, careful, I don't want to step on your foot. You're almost as bad a dancer as I am. Ouch, hey.
Pardon me, might I cut in?
Huh? I guess that'd be alright. Okay with you, Shrimpy?
Oh, no, I don't want to dance with you. I want to dance with them.
Oh, well... oh, Shrimpy? Are you sure? Alright, I'll go get us something to drink.
Ah, look, this looks interesting. A humble fortune teller.
I haven't had my fortune read since I was a little girl. All right, why don't we give it a go? Hello.
Ah, hello, your noblest majesty. Sit. Make yourself comfortable.
Well, come on, take my hand. So, you're the queen's little pet. How cute. Oh, calm down. I really meant no offense to you. I just don't understand how anyone could get close to her. She's a snake. Ow! Why, you little shit! Try to call or scream for help, and I plunge this knife through your back. Got it? Good.
Oh, dear. I see something... something terrible. Oh, Astraea, it's dreadful.
What do you see?
Diego, be calm. These things are always just a gag.
Now, here's how this is going to go, Queen's pet. We're going to slowly dance our way out of this crowd. You will not scream. You will act as if everything is normal. Then you are going to come with me.
Astraea, someone you trust will be taken from you.
Diego?
No, a peasant. I can see them now. They carry a messenger's bag on their side.
Shrimpy?
Where are they?
I'm afraid if you would like me to see more, it's going to cost you something.
Come on, Diego. We have to find them.
Good. Now, we're going to head into the woods and have a little chat. Just you and I. Got it?
Callan, where is the messenger?
Shrimpy? Why? They're out dancing. Someone asked to cut in.
Damn it, Callan, I told you to keep an eye on them. I could have you killed for this.
Astraea, calm down.
What's going on?
Shrimpy is in danger.
No. No. No, they can't be. I won't let them be. Come on.
Would you quit your struggling? Fine. I didn't want to have to do this, but you leave me no choice. By the power granted to me by the Black Mages, I bid you sleep. Sleep well and restful, for when you awake... Oh, we're going to have one hell of a time.
Please come away.
Astrea, any sign of them?
No, no one's seen them.
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god.
Callan, pull yourself together.
Callan, it's all right. We'll find them and bring them home safely. They can't have gone too far.
How could I have let them out of my sight? I was so foolish.
Do you remember what the person they were dancing with looked like?
No, their face was covered by that large hat. They wore a long black cloak.
Do you think it was one of the black mages, Diego?
No doubt.
Oh god, Shrimpy.
They must be here because of the queen destroying their camp. Astrea, we'll talk about that later. For now, it seems like only one of them was here. Let's split up. Callan, you rally the people here. I'll go get Imogen and see if we can sniff out Shrimpy.
I'll head back to the castle and rally the guard.
Your Majesty, what if they hurt them?
They won't. If it's me they want, they won't lay a hand on Sweetness. I won't let them. Now go. Let's go find them.
Good morning.
Shh.
I need you to calm down for me, okay, hun? Calm down, or I might need to send you back to the queen in pieces. You don't want that, now do you? Good. Honestly, it's nothing personal, you know. Just using you as collateral. Will you stop making that terrible noise? No one can hear you, okay? Just stay quiet and still until I'm able to lure the queen out into the woods. Hey, are you, cold? You're shaking quite a bit. Right, dumb question. I have you tied to a tree. Just... here, take my cloak. What? I'm not completely heartless. Fine. I'll take the gag off as long as you promise to keep quiet, okay? All right, then. Thank you. Please don't thank me. Seriously, don't. Why? Well, because it makes me feel guilty. There's just something about you. You're innocent and polite. It... Never mind. Stay there and stay quiet. I'm going to go get us some firewood.
Diego? What? Uncle, are you alright? What's going on?
The messenger. They've gone missing. I need your help.
Oh, God. Lily, stay here. I'll be back soon, my love.
Imogen, we don't have time. They were taken by one of the black mages.
Oh, gods above. Then let's go.
There. That should be good. Are you close enough to the fire? Good. I've got to admit, as much as I hate Cordelia, it sure is beautiful. You like the stars, huh? That constellation. Oh, wow. I didn't realize you could see it from here. Good eye. You know, you aren't freaking out as much as I thought you would. Actually, you're quite cooperative. I hope this kind of stuff doesn't happen often to you. But you remind me of someone. An old childhood friend. No, I shouldn't be telling you this. You're my prisoner. You've got time, eh? Yeah, you remind me of them. They were wonderful. Kind, hardworking, and quiet. Like they never quite knew when to say that they needed help with something. They were closed off. Maybe they just didn't know how to express it? I don't know. They didn't have the best education, so maybe they really didn't know. God, I miss them, though. They left after their father died. He could have been saved had the message that held the remedy been delivered on time. So you know what they did? They left our kingdom to... Huh? What? That was you? Oh my God. Sunshine, is that you? You're here. How did I... Oh my God, let me untie you. Come here, let me hug you. It's been so long. What am I doing here? What are you doing here? You said you left to be a messenger in Wisden. What happened? It paid more here. Well, that makes sense. I didn't even recognize you. Huh? Oh, yeah. Most call me Everly. I'm not called Eve as much anymore. Oh, but you're still welcome to call me Eve, Sunshine. I don't mind if it's you. What? Go back? No, no, you can't go back now. Darling, I don't know why they haven't killed you yet. What? You really don't know, do you? The Queen, she must have covered it up. The war with Wisteria is being told from only one point of view. The Queen destroyed Kilshire. She destroyed our home. Now, breathe. It's okay, I promise. Yes, we're all right. Those of us who are left took refuge in the next town over, closer to Wisteria's capital. She's less likely to attack there. No, oh God, no. Sugar, don't cry. Oh, come here. Let me hold you. Shh. Shh. Hmm. It's okay, my love, it's okay. King Albert is trying his best to make sure something like that never happens again. We'll be all right. I just... Why did you have to leave? Why are you here, of all places? I don't know how no one here has hurt you. I don't understand. How did I become a mage, huh? A lot of burning rage and a lot of practice. It's different, for sure. But the black mages are peacekeepers, and I wanted to conceal what I was feeling. The pain of losing you. Losing my home. The black mages taught me that. All of those things. The anger and the fear, they're valid. We acknowledge that they're here, but we never let them control us. We must just notice that the emotion is there and then let it all out. Yeah, I guess I have changed. So have you. I saw that little dance before I came to sweep you off your feet. You were so confident. Sugar, get behind me.
Ah!
Sunshine, stay down.
Shrimpy, are you all right? Are you hurt? Don't worry, I'll get you out of this.
Darling, get out of the way.
Shrimpy, you need to move.
Sugar, what do you mean stop? Okay, I'll stop.
Shrimpy, I... Okay. Now, care to explain what's going on? Your childhood best friend kidnapped you to lure the queen into a trap?
Sugar, who is this? Your boyfriend?
But boyfriend? I mean, is it too soon to call us that? I mean, yes, I'd love to court you, but... Ah, right, you're right. We'll worry about this later.
Wow, great pick. This guy is amazing. Ow! Okay, not the time. Damn, you've gotten feisty. I like it.
All right, look. Shrimpy, everyone is out looking for you. Diego has gathered vampires and the queen is gathering a guard. Well, yes, of course you'll be arrested. She took you from me, us. Don't arrest her. Shrimpy, are you okay? Did you take a hit to the head? Fine. I trust you. I'll tell the guard to leave her alone.
Stay where you are. Dear one, are you all right?
Lord Diego, stop. We have to let her go.
What? Why?
Sweetness. Oh God, you're all right. And for you, you sick, filthy little mage.
Starlight,
Your Majesty.
What? Sweetness, get out of the way! No. Did you just tell me no? Sweetness, I think you've been through a lot tonight. So, let's get back to the castle, and we can... No. We need to talk. About what? Privately. Fine. Callan, escort our guest back to the castle. Watch her like a hawk. Sweetness and I will go talk privately.
Astrea.
Diego, Go home.
Astrea, I...
Diego, home. Now.
Come along, sweetness. Let's talk.
Hello everyone, my name is Nessie Audios, the captain of this ship, and you're about to listen to the finale of the Queen series season 1. So, not to bore you with anything too much, I would like to remind everyone that we are having a Q&A Saturday, September 24th, 2022 at 3 p.m. EST. The Google form to post your questions is in the description down below. Please send any questions you would like answered. Again, I'd like to thank all the amazing VAs I've had the opportunity to work with on this project. The writer, Mo, for an amazing list of scripts. And all of you guys, YouTube and Patreon, for all the love and support. I hope everyone has had an amazing day so far. And without further ado, enjoy. I just don't understand why you're upset with me. I didn't do... Sweetness, that's not true. I would never hurt you. Whatever lies that terrible mage told you are just that. Lies. Killshire. What about Killshire? Destroyed. Why do you care? Your home. Your hysterian. Shrimpy, I... Don't yell at me! Sweetness, no. Let me speak. Be quiet and let me talk. I could have easily let you down in the dungeon with those guards, but I didn't. I could have sent you back to Wark, But I didn't. I could have left you scared and afraid. But I didn't. I took care of you. I pampered you. Hell, I made you a messenger for the nobles. I dismissed the old messenger because I liked you more. I taught you how to read. No, I was not just using you as a spy. Don't listen to that foolish woman. She's wrong. No, that's not true. I don't hate you. I don't care that you're Wisterian. Sweetness, I care about you, okay? Everyone around you has grown so attached to you. Why do you think Callan took to you? What did you say to me? No, come on. Say it again. I dare you. You don't mean that. No, sweetness, come on. I know you. I know you don't mean it. You don't hate me. I know you don't. Don't say that. Look, I'm sorry, okay? But I can't stop this war just because a few villagers get in the way. Why? It's hard to explain. No, please come back. We still can talk. Sweetness, please. Oh, God. What have I done?
Could end the war for good. She's so close. So near. That false queen is right there. And all alone. I just need to...
Astrea?
Shit! Fuck! It's that vampire. I've got to go. Yes, they'll work just fine.
Would you stop your pacing? I'm going to snap my neck watching you go back and forth like that.
Oh, shut up, will you? I just can't help but worry about them because, oh, I don't know, I actually care about them.
Hey, I never said I didn't care about them.
Oh yeah, of course, you just kidnapped them. Right. Like you care about them.
For your information, I've known them longer than you have. They forgave me, didn't they?
Only because you've put some sort of spell on them or something. God, I don't know. I'm just so worried. The Queen is terrifying.
Alright, look. Terrifying as she may be, our little sunshine is 1,000 times scarier.
How so?
They're kind. They make friends easily. People trust them. Sometimes those are the most dangerous kinds of people.
What were they like? You know, when they were younger. I want to know more about them.
Well, they were born and raised in Kilshire. They had a normal home life, a father, mother, and two younger brothers, twins. Their mother owned the tailor shop in the village, and their father worked in a coal mine. They were a very happy and intelligent child, never showed up anywhere without a smile. But that changed as they got older.
What's happened?
Well, Wisteria prides itself on the education and progression of its people. The kings of past and present all believe we can accomplish so much with knowledge. But unfortunately for Sunshine, their father had busted his leg up so bad he wasn't able to work anymore. The family wasn't making enough money, so they dropped out of school and went to work in place of their father at the coal mine. That was when their smile began to fade. Coal mining was a dangerous job. Every day they would come home exhausted and covered from head to foot in soot. They didn't have time to play with the other kids or even read, and they loved to read. But they stopped. It hurt to see their smile gone. It was like the light behind their eyes went out. For years and years, all I wanted to do was hold them, to tell them that it would be okay and that I was here for them.
You loved them?
I loved them.
What happened?
They felt like I was a distraction. We'd been dating for a few months when they decided that they needed to focus on making money. Working was the only thing on their mind. No matter how close I got to them, they would push me away. It hurt. I was their best friend for years. I was their confidant. I was their girlfriend, and suddenly there was a wall between us. The wall only came down when...
What?
When their little brother died. One of the twins.
Oh no, poor Shrimpy.
Jack. He suffered from issues when he was born. He had a hard time walking. Without a cane with him, he struggled to catch his breath. So when Jack caught a terrible illness, it killed him. And Sunshine and Harry were left without a brother. Not long after that, their father died of the same illness. The instructions for a cure were placed in a letter to their family, but it wasn't delivered on time. That's why...
They wanted to be a messenger.
That's right. Harry, Sunshine, and their mother left their ill-stricken house to move away. But Sunshine couldn't handle it. They left to be a messenger in Wisden, but... Well, I guess they ended up here. I haven't seen them since.
I had no idea.
How could you have? All that time being a child and having to work long, painful hours made them reserved and quiet. You're lucky, you know. They seem to have opened up to you quite a bit.
Yes, I guess they have, and Everly. I'm sorry. I guess I should admit something. The first time I met them, I sort of arrested them for treason.
Oh my god.
Yeah, it was bad. But I brought them cake. They really like cake.
They do. They're lucky to have you looking out for them. You're a good boyfriend.
Callan.
But if you do anything to break their heart, I'll break your spine. You got that, hun?
I won't let anything happen to them. I promise.
Darling.
I told them to be quiet. I destroyed their home.
Their home?
they thought I was going to hurt them too.
Starlight, calm down. We'll figure this out, okay? I promise.
There's no way they want to see me right now. I don't think they'll ever talk to me again. God, what if they run away? What if we can't find them again?
Astrea, you need to calm down, okay? Breathe with me.
I can't. Oh God, what have I done? What have I done?
Astrea, breathe. Look, look into my eyes, okay? Now, deep breath in. And out. One more time. In. And out. Better?
A bit. Can you just hold me like this for a bit?
Of course. I'm not going anywhere. We'll stay here as long as you need.
Thank you, Diego. You're a good friend.
Oh my gosh!
Are you okay? That looked like it hurt. Here, let me help you up. There you go. Of course. I'm happy to help. Let you go. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm not going to. Hey, now. There's no point in screaming. Your friends are either crying on the forest floor, or just simply not around. Either way, no one is coming to save you. No struggling, dearie. I don't want you getting hurt now. Why don't you all still for me? Very gently.
I've done it! We need poor Evelyn's another job to finish the job. So you're just gonna have to come with me. Okay.
'Your Majesty, but where's Shrimpy?
They're not with you?
No, we thought they were still talking with you.
What? No. They left over an hour ago.
An hour ago? And no one thought to follow them?
They ran off into the forest. I thought they wanted to be alone.
Maybe they just went back to the festival.
The festival is over. It ended when the panic of their missing started. Everyone went home. Perhaps they went to visit a friend.
Can they?
Everyone stop. I know what happened. Look.
A delivery dove. Hello there, little one. Do you mind if I... Thank you. To whomever may find this note... Tell your queen that her time of surrender draws near.
We have your messenger. I am not afraid to do whatever is necessary to end this war, until the time your queen sees it fit to surrender. They will be staying with me, spilling every little secret about Her Majesty. And believe me, they can try to resist, but I have ways of making them talk.
Warmest regards, His Majesty King Albert Goodman V, King of Wisteria.
Together, ashes, ashes, the kingdom falls down.